Dear students, today's topic is leaf. Last class, we have seen about different types of stem and the stem modification. Today we are going to see about the leaf. Leaves are the green, thin, flattened lateral outgrowth of the stem. Leaves are the primary photosynthetic organs and the main place of transpiration. All the leaves of a plant collectively called phloem. What is phloem? All the leaves of the plant is called phloem. Come to the characteristic feature of a leaf. The leaves are the lateral appendages of the stem. The leaf produces at the node of the stem. You know the node. Node is a part of the stem which produces a leaf or branches or flowers, etc. The leaves are exogenous in origin because they are produced from the outermost part of the stem, outermost part of the node of the stem, that is exogenous in origin. Leaf has a limited growth, apical bud is absent. Each leaf has three parts. One is leaf base, second one petiole, third one leaf lamina. Leaf lamina contain vascular strands called veins of the leaf lamina. Come to the functions of the leaf. In leaf also there are two functions. One is primary function, second one is secondary function. The primary functions are the main functions of the leaf: photosynthesis, transpiration, gases exchange, protection of buds, conduction of water and dissolved solutes. These are all the primary functions of the leaf. Leaves are the main organs to carry out photosynthesis. It's the site of photosynthesis. Transpiration takes place through the stomata of the leaves. What is transpiration? When the excess amount of water is evaporated through the stomata of the leaves, that is called transpiration. Gases exchange takes place for photosynthesis and respiration through the stomata of the leaves. Protection of buds. The leaves will protect the young buds, axillary buds, terminal buds, etc. A number of buds are produced from the stem. They are well protected by the leaves. The leaves will conduct water and also dissolved solutes. The veins of the leaf conduct water towards the leaf lamina and it conducts dissolved solutes away from the leaf lamina, because the solutes are prepared in the leaf lamina and the prepared solutes, prepared carbohydrate, prepared food materials are translocated to various parts of the plant by the leaves. Secondary functions are special functions carried out by the leaves along with the primary function. What are the secondary functions? Storage, protection, support, reproduction. These are all considered as a secondary function. The storage function is carried out by, for example, allow, agave, Kalanjo, Sedum, Brassica oleracea. These are all the plants in which in the leaves of these plants the food materials are stored. The second function, second secondary function is protection. For example, the berberis, opuntia, argimon mexicana, here the leaves are modified into spines and that will protect the plants from grazing animals. The third function is support. Gloriosa, for example, gloriosa and nepenthes, a part of the leaf is modified into tendril and the tendril is used for giving support to the plant so that the plant will grow erect. The tendril will catch hold the support so that the stem of the gloriosa, the stem of the nepenthes will grow erect. So that is the support function. Reproduction, in the case of bryophyllum, in begonia, in zamioculcus, the leaf lamina will produce a new plant. And that is the vegetative reproduction considered as far as bryophyllum, begonia, zamioculcus is concerned. Come to the pores of the leaf. Each leaf has three pores. One is leaf base, considered as hypopodium. Second one is petiole, mesopodium. Third one is leaf lamina, that is otherwise called epipodium. Come to the leaf base, hypopodium. It is a part of the leaf. It is a basal part of the leaf attached to the node of the stem, and that is called leaf base. It protects the growing buds at its axil. See, this is the basal part of the petiole. Stalk of the leaf is called petiole. The basal part of the leaf is called leaf base, which is attached with the stem. And that is the leaf base. The function of the leaf base is to protect the growing buds at its axil. Axil means this is the axil of the leaf. The angle formed between the stem and the petiole of the leaf above, that is the axil of the leaf. At the axil of the leaf, at the axil of every leaf, there is a bud that is called axillary bud. That the axillary bud is well protected by the leaf base. In legumes, in the case of pulses yielding plants, the leaf base is, the leaf base become broad and swollen. Such a swollen leaf base is called pulvinus. For example, in the case of clitoria, in lamblum, in cassia, in erythrina, in butia, and peltophorum, the swollen leaf base can be seen very clearly. This is the swollen leaf base. When the leaf base is swollen, bulged, and that is the swollen leaf base considered as the pulvinus. Mainly in the case of legume plants, all the legume plants, all the pulses yielding plants, the swollen leaf base can be seen. In most of the cases, the swollen leaf base can be seen. Come to the sheathing leaf base. In some of the cases, in many monocot families like Aricaceae, Musaceae, Gingiberaceae, and Poaceae, the leaf base extends into a sheath and clasps a part of the internode or whole of the internode. This is broad leaf base, that is sheathing leaf base. The broad sheathing leaf base covers the stem to some extent. A part of the internode is covered, or the whole internode can be covered by the sheathing leaf base. The leaf base in some of the plant leave permanent scars on the stem, when the leaf fall off. This can be noticed in coconut tree, palm tree, etc. Come to the petiole. Petiole is always called stipe or mesopodium. The petiole, this is the petiole, this is the petiole. The stalk of the leaf is called petiole. It is cylindrical or sub-cylindrical or flattened in some of the cases. So it may be cylindrical or it may be sub-cylindrical or it may be flattened structure in some of the cases. The petiole is the bridge between leaf lamina and the stem. This is the stem, this is the leaf lamina. In between leaf lamina and the stem, the petiole is acting as a bridge between the leaf lamina and the stem. A leaf with petiole is called petiolate. For example, ficus, hibiscus, etc. The petiole can be seen. When there is a petiole present in the leaf is said to be petiolate. The leaf without petiole is called sessile. For example, in the case of Calotropis, erukanjedi, in Calotropis, petiole is absent. So the leaf lamina directly attached with the stem. So that is the condition in the case of Calotropis. Come to leaf lamina. The green expanded part of the leaf is called leaf lamina. Green, flattened, expanded part of the leaf, that is called leaf lamina. The leaf lamina is always called leaf blade or epipodium. The leaf lamina, it is the seat of photosynthesis. Gaseous etching takes place in the leaf lamina through the stomata of the leaf for photosynthesis and respiration. Transpiration also takes place through the stomata of the leaf lamina. And in most of the metabolic reactions of the plant takes place in the leaf lamina. At the middle of the leaf lamina, there is a midrib. And the midrib will give out a number of branches that is called lateral vein. The lateral vein produces a number of small veins that is called veinlets. Shape, margin, surface, texture, color, venation and incision of the leaf lamina differs from one plant to another. So that is about the leaf lamina. Leaf lamina is the main part of the plant, main part of the leaf, and that is considered as the main part of the plant because the leaf lamina carry out photosynthesis, that is the main function of all the green plants. During photosynthesis, carbohydrate is prepared. So the food materials of the plants are prepared. Food materials of the plants are prepared in the leaf lamina only. So that is about the leaf. Today we have seen about the leaf in general, characteristic feature of the leaf, functions of the leaf, pores of the leaf. In the pores of the leaf, there are three pores we have studied. One is leaf base, second one is petiole, and third one is leaf lamina. That's all about the leaf. Today's topic is over. That's all. Thank you.